Although these transceivers look identical from the outside, they have a completely different laser technology inside. If you want to find out why, please stick around and we'll check it out. There are two types of semiconductor lasers which are typically used in optical transceivers. On the one hand, we have the DFB lasers, and on the other hand, we have the so-called VCSELs. VCSEL is an acronym for Vertical Cavity Surface Emitting Laser. This simply means the light is exiting the chip just from the top, perpendicularly. The DFB, it's also an acronym for Distributed Feedback Laser, and this is a typical edge emitter. So this means, if you take a look on the chip, you can see there's this waveguide or laser stripe, and the light is exiting at the edge of the chip. Due to the fact that this waveguide is quite wide but very thin, and the mechanism diffraction, this means that the profile of the beam is quite elliptical. In contrast to that, the VCSEL has a more or less perfectly circled shape. It's more or less a Gaussian beam. So this has some advantages, but also some disadvantages. And for that, let's skip to this screen here. On the left-hand side, once again, DFB, right, we have VCSELs. And for example, the coupling. So for the application, you have to couple the light, the laser light, into a fiber. This is done by means of a lens or something like that. And it's a little bit easier with the VCSEL than with the DFB, because you have a more or less Gaussian beam with the VCSEL. The testing during the production can be done for the VCSELs on wafer level, while for the DFB you have to do some dicing processes or something like that. Monitoring in our component, in the assembled component, it's much easier with the DFB than with the VCSEL. You need a more complex optical setup. And yeah, there's one point, the availability. So the VCSELs are very common in the multimode 850 nanometer area, but the DFB is produced in millions or billions, and even in the 1300 or 1500 nanometer range. There are some developments, or let's say it's there is some wavelength are available as VCSELs in single mode, but this is a way where there needs some improvement. And a very very important point is the power consumption. It's well known that the VCSEL has a much lower power consumption than the DFB, and nowadays this can be a big advantage. So now the reason is, or this is a reason why there are so many developments in direction of the VCSELs. Now, to give you an idea of the sizes we are talking, so this is the transceiver I talked before in the intro, and here you can see a TO can, and now we take a closer look with a microscope into this TO can. We opened it. On the left-hand side, once again, here is a DFB laser, and you can see it here. So this is the laser stripe. The light is exiting the DFB edge, or the chip edge here, and goes out of the through the window out of the TO can. By the way, at the bottom you can see the monitor diode. And on the left-hand side, once again, this is the TO can with a window on top. Here you can see the DFB laser. So this is the aperture where the light comes out, and so the light is emitted vertically. I hope you learned something today. If so, please leave a comment, especially if you have your own thoughts on advantages or disadvantages for the two sorts of lasers. And yeah, see you in one of the next videos. Bye-bye.